The 2020 Atlas Cross Sport represents a crucial play for Volkswagen as the German automotive giant aims to carve out a sizable new chunk of the five-seat SUV segment. The Cross Sport's debut took place at the Chattanooga, Tennessee factory, where it will roll off the same lines as the Atlas and Passat. The event took place with a massive employee audience alongside local politicians, including Tennessee Governor Bill Lee and Congressman Chuck Fleischmann.
America's looking for. It's big, it's bold, excuse the language, it's a little bit badass, and it's an American SUV, and that's exactly what the market wants. Now the exterior is one thing, of course we'll jump into the interior, significantly upgraded materials, bold and attractive, and all of the latest technology that you would expect, wireless charging, Wi-Fi capability, traffic jam assist, and of course connectivity to all of the driver assistance systems on the interior of the vehicle. Of course, as I mentioned, if you want to have a social activity, you need space. More legroom and cargo space than a Grand Cherokee, 40 inches versus 38, significantly more cargo area than the number one selling five-seater. So this is a massive competitive advantage, looks good, has the latest tech, and of course has the space that Americans are desiring. And of course, on top of that thing, you need the performance. V6, four-cylinder turbos. Of course, the four-cylinder now, for the first time, will be available with four-motion all-wheel drive. And finally, you have to price it competitively, and I assure you, this vehicle will be competitively priced. You deserve to have a stunning vehicle. You deserve to arrive in this type of vehicle, but it's one thing to do it at $70,000. It's a whole other thing to do it where we belong, in the $30,000 price range for this vehicle. You know, obviously, these vehicles do not build themselves, as I've been saying. We are surrounded by the employees who really bring their passion and bring their precision to bring this vehicle to life. And we've been discussing with the governor, we are extremely proud to bring 1,000 additional jobs in the building of the electric vehicle and, of course, in the building of this Atlas Cross Sport. So together with the hundreds of thousands of Volkswagen employees around the globe, this is a powerful strength and an asset that we have. It's an asset and a strength that we want to continue to take advantage of and continue to show the magic that we are capable of. You know, and if you look at the brand ourselves, I think there is one thing to make a vehicle, there's one thing to sell a vehicle, but for us at Volkswagen, and this is true around the world, we always want to do more. We want our vehicles to honestly become vehicles of change in and of themselves. It's not enough to make them, and it's not enough just to sell them. So in light of that, what we are doing today, and right now in this plant, we have nearly 100 veterans who are working in this factory. And frankly, I could not think of another group of people who embody this higher purpose we are aiming for as a brand. So ladies and gentlemen, tell this story quite simplistically. This tall, skinny guy who looks a little bit lost in this picture is my father. A kid from Brooklyn who went into the military, and frankly, when he came out, America had opportunities for him. He pursued those opportunities. That's how I got here. That's how my five brothers and sisters navigated the world. And that's, of course, how he went on to purchase a Volkswagen Beetle that we all went around town in. But it's a country that had an opportunity for him when he returned. And that's exactly what we in America need to continue to do, that we have these opportunities when our veterans return from service. We have a responsibility, but I think we also have a massive opportunity to do that. In order to bring this to life, we are announcing today a partnership with Hiring Our Heroes. And to me, it's quite straightforward. We want to and we will recruit veterans for all of our facilities across the United States, whether it's a factory, whether it's a dealership, whether it's a port, whether it's at our headquarters. So this is the magic, and this is what we want to do. Look, it's quite clear. Something big is creating good jobs. Something bigger is using the tools that we have at our disposal to create opportunities for people who've earned it more than any other. And that's exactly what we intend to do. So, in closing, straightforward, thank you very much to the press, to all of the government officials, to all of the magical employees who make this great brand happen in America. Thank you for joining us. We told you about a great car. It's you. We told you about a great brand. And of course, we've told you the great things we want to continue to do here in Chattanooga. And Governor Lee, if you please come up and join me. And Congressman, let's take a couple of photos and celebrate this great car. Thank you very much, everybody.